been called the gunless struggle, Kashmir's own intifada, or sponsored agitational terrorism. Welcome to 30 Minutes, and in the next half an hour, we are going to bring you an insight into the phenomena of stone rage, a phenomena which has no single identity and no single reason.
The entry to Srinagar's main trouble spot, Maisuma, is as dodgy as this razor wire. Almost on every other day, and right through the last fortnight, the lanes of Maisuma have found the stone pelters and security forces fighting bloody street battles. Shabir, not his real name, is familiar with every corner and by lane of the Maisuma maze, also called Kashmir's Gaza Strip. A university student, he is as passionate about Adidas and Nike as hurling bricks at the police and CRPF, who chase him and hundreds of his fellow stone pelters through these crooked lanes of Maisuma.
I don't endorse guns. I don't endorse stones. I love to hold a pen in my hand. I'm not even a criminal. We are also an educated person, but it is Kashmir Intifada this time. So we are on the grounds only for our purpose, only for our democratic right.
Barely 50 miles away in Baramulla, hub of the Jamaatul Islami, this group prepares for what they call the Friday 2020. Young boys, barely 16 and 18 years old, who flaunt bullets around their necks and show off their rubber shell injuries. Some run shops, some are unemployed, but when the masks come on, they become stone pelters. And in the past 3 weeks, the number of stone pelters and the areas in which they are active has risen sharply. The targets are chosen carefully. The CRPF and local police are popular targets, while army trucks often get a safe passage. As the stones fly around, you even spot young boys at the center of it all, some just 6 or 7 years old.
7 साल, 6 साल के लड़के होते हैं, छोटे-छोटे बच्चे, उनके पास भी जज्बा है। जज्बे के खिलाफ हम नहीं जा सकते।